Good morning, everyone, and a big thank you to Ian for the opportunity to provide an update on Telstra's financial results for the half year ended 31 December 2021. It was a really important half for us. In the half, we saw our underlying business continue to grow. We saw the benefits of our T22 strategy flowing through for our customers and for our shareholders. And we announced the transition to T25, our new strategy for growth. We achieved these results because we stayed disciplined and focused on delivering what we said we would. Our T22 strategy has been a clear success. We are now a vastly different company and we are determined to finish the job. Let me start with the recent announcement by our chairman on CEO retirement and succession. As many of you may know, Andy Penn has announced his intention to retire after serving more than 7 years as CEO. I will officially take over as CEO on 1 September 2022 and will work with Andy over the coming months to ensure a really smooth transition. I am excited and humbled to be chosen to serve as Telstra's next CEO. It is a great company of talented and committed people who constantly inspire me in the way they go above and beyond to deliver for our customers and for our shareholders. As a mum of two young daughters, I'm also proud to be the first CEO, female CEO of Telstra, and hope it inspires them to stay resilient and chase their dreams. Having grown up in the small New South Wales country town of Holbrook, with a population of just 1,400 people, where everyone knew the telecom technician, I am very aware of Telstra's heritage and the important role it plays connecting Australians and taking that connectivity to the world. With that, let me turn to our results on the next slide. FY22 is a pivotal year for Telstra financially, as we see the near final negative effects of the NBN in our reported results and the growing momentum in our underlying performance showing through. On a reported basis, total income for the half decreased 9.4% to $10.9 billion. NPAT decreased 34% to $0.7 billion. And earnings per share was down 35.9% to 5.9 cents per share. On top of the impact of the NBN, these declines also reflect the one-off gains last year from the sale of certain assets. In contrast to our reported results, our underlying numbers show financial momentum. Underlying EBITDA on a guidance basis increased 5.1% to $3.5 billion. This was the second consecutive half of underlying EBITDA growth. And underlying EPS was up 55% to 6.2 cents per share, a strong start against our T25 ambition of growing underlying EPS at a CAGR in the high teens from FY21 to FY25. The board resolved to pay a fully franked interim dividend of 8 cents per share, returning around $940 million to shareholders. While this is the same level of interim dividend as last year, it is worth noting it includes an increase in the ordinary dividend from 5 to 6 cents per share. Turning to the next slide and our operating highlights for the half. We continue to see good customer growth in mobiles despite the impact of COVID on population growth and our retail presence. We added 84,000 net retail postpaid mobile services, including 62,000 branded, with a strong contribution from enterprise. Our branded performance reinforces the benefits of our clear leadership in 5G. Our continued focus on mobile network leadership and building value resulted in 6.3% mobile services revenue growth and $392 million mobile EBITDA growth. Our performance for consumer and small business fixed customers has been more challenged, particularly as we are now at the tail end of the migration to the NBN and dealing with the more difficult cases. We are confident of restoring momentum by leveraging the benefits of our many value-adding home broadband features. These include the Telstra Smart Modem, Telstra TV, the Telstra Wi-Fi Guarantee, and our new 5G fixed wireless offer. In enterprise, we return to income and EBITDA growth in the half, and we are on track to deliver growth for the full year. Telstra Health had a strong half, both operationally and strategically. Revenue was up 9% or 37% after including the Medical Director and Power Health acquisitions. Our customer experience continued to improve, with episode NPS up 11 points in the last 12 months and 5 points in the last six. Finally, on our operating highlights, we've made very strong progress in our productivity program. For the half, underlying fixed costs were down $254 million and total operating expenses were down $644 million, or 8%. Turning to the next slide and our clear financial momentum. The left-hand side of this slide shows the growth we have achieved in underlying EBITDA in the last three halves, including $3.5 billion this half. Against this, our guidance for the full year is $7 to $7.3 billion, which indicates growth again in the second half. The chart on the right shows the evolution of our full-year underlying EBITDA, including our ambition to be in the range of $7.5 to $8 billion in FY23 and our T25 ambition for mid-single-digit CAGR out to 2025. These statements for FY23 and FY25 are not guidance, they are ambitions, which means that there are greater risks and uncertainties associated with them compared to our normal guidance statements. Nonetheless, the charts clearly demonstrate our ongoing financial momentum and our ambition for further growth. With that, let me turn to the next slide and our progress with T22. We have completed or are on track to deliver over 80% of our T22 scorecard metrics as we enter the final 3 months. Today, I will highlight just a few of our many T22 achievements. Details on our achievements and financial results are available from our Investor Centre website on telstra.com. Since announcing T22, we have radically simplified our business, reducing the number of consumer and small business plans from 1,800 to 20, and we now have 9.4 million services on them. We have removed lock-in contracts, excess data, and many other fees. We have 4 million customers signed up to our rewards program, Telstra Plus, and we are seeing strong engagement with NPS for customers who are members of Telstra Plus around 20 points higher than customers who are not. The number of calls coming into our consumer and small business contact centres has fallen by 70%. And by the end of this financial year, we expect to answer all of these calls in Australia. We have monetised over $2 billion of assets, further strengthening our balance sheet. This is in addition to the sale of a 49% non-controlling stake in our towers business for $2.8 billion, which was finalised in the first half. In network leadership, our 5G network is now more than twice the size of our nearest competitor. We cover more than 77.5% of the population with 2.8 million 5G devices already connected. On infrastructure, the business has been operating for some time as a standalone business unit under the leadership of Brendan Riley. In March, we outlined the steps to finalise our legal restructure, including a scheme meeting and shareholder vote expected to occur before or at the 2022 Telstra AGM. Next slide, please. In terms of finishing the job on T22 over the remaining few months of this financial year, our key focus areas include the group restructure to drive value from InfraCo and create optionality while preserving Telstra's core differentiation. further improving customer experience, including the completion of bringing our stores in-house and our consumer and small business call centres onshore. Further consolidating our position as Australia's largest 5G network with 80% population coverage, starting to scale our energy business and delivering high teens growth in health revenues before acquisitions, ceasing sale and new development on the old technology stack while migrating at scale to the new one, continuing to deliver operating momentum, including in mobile SIOs, Telstra Plus, media services, and turning around performance in fixed consumer and small business. And finally, delivering our $2.7 billion annualised productivity target. Next slide, please. With that, let me turn briefly to T25, our new strategy announced last September. As you may know, like T22, T25 is built around four key strategic pillars, which you can see on the slide. T25 is a strategy focused on growth by leveraging the capabilities we have built under T22. In the same way, T22 would not have been possible without the foundational investments we announced in 2016, T25 would not be possible without all that we have accomplished in T22. This is why we are so focused on finishing the job on T22. Although T25 does not start until next financial year, we have already made good early progress. For example, the recent Telecommunications Industry Ombudsman quarterly complaints report showed our complaint numbers fell 50% in the second quarter of FY22 compared to the same quarter last year. In February, we announced a landmark 10-year regional multi-operator core network commercial agreement with TPG and two major telecommunications infrastructure projects to enable unprecedented levels of connectivity across Australia. And while not strictly contemplated in our T25 strategy, in October last year, we announced the acquisition in partnership with the Australian government of Digicel Pacific. We look forward to finalising the acquisition in due course. So while we have not transitioned to T25, we are putting in place the initiatives that will fuel our growth. With that, let me close with the last slide, thanks. The transformation of Telstra and our turnaround has continued, and we are well positioned for growth. Our first half results clearly demonstrate financial momentum and strong underlying growth. We have confidence this momentum will continue, driven by product growth, delivery of productivity, and diversifying our growth, including in infrastructure, health, energy, and through the Digicel acquisition. We've stayed disciplined on the execution of T22, and our hard work is paying off. The benefits are flowing through for our customers and our shareholders. We're delivering a better customer experience. We have removed many pain points and we have raised the bar on doing business responsibly. Our mobile network remains Australia's biggest and best. Our T22 program has been a clear success and we are determined to finish the job and complete the transition to T25. I'm excited by the future and the opportunities in front of us. And so, Ian, I'll now hand back to you to go through some Q&A.